I've got two boys, and I thought I'd try for a girl because I figured that a girl might look after me when I get a bit older.
Yeah.
And I've got twin boys on the back of that. I've got one who's causing a bit of trouble at the moment.
So. Oh, really? They do that.
What do I do about that?
What do you do about that? Well, like I said, you know, I have a 19-year-old, so the only trouble that I actually have with him is he steals all my clothes, which I take as a compliment, actually. You know, a 19-year-old wanting to wear his 43-year-old dad's clothes, it gets annoying at times, I must admit, because there's certain moments where I go to look for a pair of jeans and he's wearing them or he's worn them and they're on the floor. So that's the only trouble that I really have with him.
What's on your bucket list that you will do next?
Bucket list that I will do next. One of the things that I always wanted to do was bring my kids to Australia, because obviously I'd been here 7 years ago, you know, and then was in Melbourne 6 years ago. And I enjoyed it so much that I always said to Victoria, you know, one day when we have the opportunity, we'll take the kids. And it's always challenging because obviously the kids have school, but it just worked out that this moment kind of came up naturally, obviously my involvement with the Invictus Games.
And being a part of the AIO family now, does that mean you barrack for Tottenham?
to be honest, I've always, my second team really, my first team was always Manchester United, but my second team was always Tottenham because my granddad was a season ticket holder at Tottenham for 50 years. He sadly passed away about 7 years ago, but he was, you know, my dad used to buy me the Manchester United strip for Christmas, and then in the afternoons we used to go to my nan and granddad's house, and my granddad used to get me the Tottenham strip, so I used to have to kind of just keep them both happy. My second team has always been Tottenham, and they're at such a high at the moment. You know, they've got a great manager, a great young team, obviously a new stadium that they're going to move into. So, you know, things are looking good for them.
Now, I'm a similar age to you, and I've followed all your hairstyles.
You do have good hair, to be fair.
Oh, thank you very much. I was going to ask you, what can I do with my hair now? It's going grey. But I followed your style when it was blonde.
Yeah.
But I did it myself, so it sort of went orange, but right. A Caribbean gold.
It does go orange.
An
auburn
sunset.
Time. Yeah.
I had issues with that. But you've always been one that's had great style.
Yeah.
So what does someone like myself, as you get a bit older, what do you do? How do you stay in touch?
I think you've just got to be classic. You've just got to keep it classic. That's what I've tried to do now. You've done well, to be fair, because I've had the same hairstyle now for the last few years. You know, I shaved it off recently and. Obviously I'm growing it back a little bit now, so you know, as long as you keep it a classic style, you know, the way you look, the way you dress, I think when you get to a certain age there's certain things that you shouldn't be wearing, so those are the things, you know, a cap back to front, you know.
Yep.
For instance,
yeah, I'll do that.
I was doing that the other day and my son was like, "Dad, really, are you not a bit old for that now?" Which I obviously replied, "No, not at all," but it made me think.
Fit to your room.
It made me think.